When I take your breath, you fill up my lungs. And if my mind work backwards, it's for a minute.
My name's Josh Griffin, and I play professional rugby for Salford. I'm from Oxford, so I played rugby union as I was a kid. It wasn't until I moved to Yorkshire when I was 14 that I started playing rugby league, and that was just through friends at school. Something I've like fallen upon. I enjoy both of them really. I've played both professionally now, but like I say, what you do get from league fans, they're a lot more passionate, so it's probably more the fans than anything. I started over in Yorkshire and Wakefield and Cass, and I went to rugby union. I was looking to come back to rugby league, and Salford at the time were looking for a player in my position, and they just gave me an opportunity to come over, and I've loved it since. I leave a lot faster. Used to feel like when I come off from a rugby union field, I reckon I could play again. Whereas a rugby league field, I don't think I could play for a week. It's a lot more intense. My dad was a big idol for me, you know. He pushed me into rugby, and I was like, because he played when he was younger. My older brother as well, he's another one. He's about 10 years older than me, and obviously he played a lot, and he started playing professional when he was 17, so I was 7. So that was something I looked up to. Probably Johnny Wilkinson as well, from a professional point of view. I don't know, like I say, it was around that era when he won the World Cup, 2003, that I was really into my rugby as a kid, and that was someone I just looked up to. To make a good one, so obviously you've got natural talent, but it's more about attitude. You can be the best player in the world, if you ain't got the right attitude, then it's not, you've got to give up a lot of stuff from when you're younger. So it's commitment to the sport. When all your friends are going out drinking on a Friday or Saturday night, you've got to put yourself away and just worry about the game ahead.
So that was like your patron of Super Josh. So what's that all about, and are you proud of that you've taken part of this charity?
Yeah, like that's a charity that's really close to the club. Obviously his ashes are spread on the field. So it was something when my first year when Josh was still alive, it obviously with my name being Josh as well, he called me Super Josh as well. And it was just something that went about that way, and when he sadly passed the year after, they asked me to become a patron. And it's one I'm really proud of being part of.
Would you say anything to people who wanted to become like you, a professional player? What would you tell them to do on and off the field?
Just practice. That's a big one. Just make sure you get your training in, and just stick at it. Obviously, like I say, when it gets tough, it does. And if you really set yourself some goals, it's all about just sticking to them and not getting caught up in life, really. It's all about using rugby as something to aim for. We're all in it together, Some people have bad games on and off, you're not at your best every week, and that's what a team's about, If someone's down, you pick up and push it on for them.